Right now, many of Minnesota's animal shelters are at capacity. In today's Communities That Care, Eva Anderson introduces us to a nonprofit animal rescue working on reducing the stress on shelters by expanding their foster program.
With playful, purring Coconut and Chip all cozy.
She's got a comfy little spot in there.
It's easy to forget where they were just days before.
When Coconut arrived, she was pretty matted. Chip, she struggled. They were in a bad situation. The owner was homeless and couldn't provide care.
Now, safely in the care of foster-based rescue Pet Haven, Coconut and Chip are being treated to make sure they're ready to enter foster homes.
Even Chip's starting to come out of her shell a little bit.
They came from the organization's Owner Surrender Program, a program the nonprofit tripled in size to meet the need during the pandemic.
It really helps owners knowing that their pets are going to a family, into a home, rather into a shelter.
Executive Director Carrie D'Amato has worked in animal welfare for 30 years and says she's never seen so many animals in shelters or abandoned.
Minnesota's in a little bit of a crisis. We're finding pets left in carriers at Cub Food. We're finding pets tied up to fences.
She attributes this pattern to well-intentioned but ill-prepared pet owners who adopted during the pandemic, now getting rid of their furry friends as they head back into the office. And now inflation, too.
Resources are low, people are struggling, expenses are going up, and oftentimes the first place people have to cut expenses to survive is their pets.
Pet Haven is rising to the challenge, connecting owners with free resources to make surrendering a very last option. They provide essentials like litter and pet food to food banks. And to serve those for whom surrender is the only option, they expanded their volunteer base to take in pets like Zipper.
He's a slow mover. We thought if we called him Zipper, he might start moving a little quicker.
And they're encouraging others to step up and foster.
One person has a huge impact on the animal welfare community in Minnesota by just opening up their heart and home to a pet.
In addition to fostering a pet, there are other ways you can help. They're always taking donations of supplies as well as financial gifts, and you can volunteer your time with administrative duties.
Volunteers that process the applications.
They're hoping with everyone playing a part to solve this crisis, they can turn a corner.
Oh, there he goes. He's zipping his way to his room.
Eva Anderson, Care 11 News.
If you'd like to get involved, we have that information on our website. Of course, that's care11.com. Right now, over to